Okay, so I am checking out a new location. This is a spot where I might be bringing a client here in a few days. Actually, I'm going to turn around and show you where I am. I'm actually at the very back of a cemetery. It's kind of terrible, but trying not to go too fast here. But what I noticed when I drove by this spot is we've got a really nice tree line and there's some really good light. The trees are great for diffusing the light. Just a really pretty backdrop, something a little bit different. I usually shoot in more wide open spaces, so I wanted to try something new. We're about 2 hours before sunset, so the sun is still pretty high, and you can see it's just right above that tree line. So it's a little bit high right now, but it's going to be going down behind those trees soon. But just the trees gives me a lot of flexibility because they're diffusing the sun. So I'm going to show you a couple of different things. I've got my daughter here, and I'm going to show you a couple of different things, what I can do, the difference with placing her completely in the shade and placing her in some of these patches of sunlight and what that does for the photo. So just kind of some experimenting with light that I want to show you. Okay, for these, I've got her completely in the shade, and I'll show you kind of what we've got. Can you look right here? Good job. You're pretty. If you want to do some twirling, you can. Do you want to do some twirling? Ooh, that's pretty. Do you want to twirl the other way? This is one of her favorite things to do, is to twirl. Okay, good job. Okay, we're gonna move into a sunny spot, okay? Okay, and so now I've moved her just to the edge of the shade and sun, the line of shade and sun on in front of those trees. You can see that now she's got some light behind her. And I'm gonna show you the difference in these photos. Look right here. You are pretty. Good job. And just what we end up with is now she's got some really pretty rim light. And normally I'd be taking shots from other angles, but I've got my phone here on top of my camera. Look at your hand, where your hand is holding that dress, Nora. Oh, wow. Is your dress beautiful? Look at it. Tell me what color it is over there by your hand. Look to your right hand. Can you look at your right hand? Oh, that's so pretty. Good job. Stay right there. That's really pretty. Good job. Hey, Nora. Pickle sandwich. Do you want to do some more twirling? Go for it. Good job. Sorry, my camera turned a little bit there, guys. But this way I can kind of show you the difference of being totally in the shade or when you have a little bit of sunlight. What happens when you can use that to your advantage, just how it gives a little bit of light behind them. So I'm going to show you some examples, some of these photos. I'm also going to come and have the light to her side and just show you the difference and the reason why I have the sun behind her. Okay, so for this one now, I have come around to her left. The sun is now to our right. So Nora, can you face mom? There you go. And what I want you to see is the difference in how the sun is right across the side of her face. This is why I had the sun at her back, because now she's got some harsh shadows on her face. Can you look right here, honey? Good job. Do you want to brush your hair out of your face, sweetie? You can brush your hair out of your face. No? Say pickle sandwich. Is that what you had for lunch today?
No.
Good job. So again, sorry that I have my phone on a little thing on top of my camera. It likes to twist. It won't stay very tight. So sorry that's turning, but hopefully that gives you guys kind of an idea of ways to use light and how to use the various light around you when you're in a situation like this. So again, just what I'm looking for is instead of putting her totally way back there against those trees in total shade, I decided to bring her out, and the best shots that I got were when I brought her right to the edge of that shade where she was in the sun. And the reason why I do that, why I bring her to the edge of the shade and not fully out in the sun, is simply because then it keeps me from having to have a blown out background. I can still have nice even lighting. So I just want to show you the reason why I brought her just to the edge before of the shade is because when I bring her further out into the sun, then you have all of that bright grass behind her and it kind of leaves a blown out look where I prefer the look of the even lighting behind them. So I'm going to show you a few pictures where I brought her out further from the shade line of the trees. And that way you can kind of see what I mean. So when I take pictures of her here, can you look here, honey? Good job. You don't have to even hold your dress. You can twirl if you'd like. Good job. Okay, can you stop right there? Good job. Oh, look at that. Posing and everything. And the reason why I'm doing this is to show you, now you've kind of got this really bright grass behind her and then really dark grass, where if you bring them just right to the edge of the shade line, then you've got nice even lighting behind you. So just something to think about. These are fun things to experiment with when you're out on location. So just a few thoughts.